Hai YNS Fellas, I'm Gilang Arif Pratama as a consultant at YNS Indonesia. In this episode, we'll talk about Indonesia's electric vehicle. So, welcome to our deep dive Indonesia's electric vehicle push and its economic impact. By 2024, Indonesia driving a significant shift at its economic landscape by positioning itself as a pivot player, holding approximately 25% of the world nickel reserve. By 2027, Indonesia projected aim to produce 1 million electric vehicles annually, positioning itself as a global electric vehicle manufacturing hub. In 2022 alone, Indonesia has secured $5 billion in FDI from key global players such as Tesla. But this opportunity for Indonesia comes also with environment concern. Indonesia need to involving balancing economic growth with sustainable practices, particularly in nickel extraction and processing. Despite the rapid investment and industrial growth, challenges persist. Indonesia has to improve their infrastructure and supply chain capabilities to boost their electric vehicle markets. Indonesia's government also had a crucial role, and there has been any movement that Indonesia's government has been done, which is introducing policies that support green manufacturing by investing $35 billion in infrastructure improvement and targeting for 23% of the national energy mix to come from renewable by 2025. Indonesia's government has implemented a range of policies to support EV adoption and production. These include tax exemption on EV import, subsidies for battery manufacturers, and plans to phase out internal combustion engine vehicle by 2050. Additionally, consumers are eligible for rebates of up to 47,000 per electric car, boosting domestic demand. By 2025, the government anticipates 20% of all vehicles sold in Indonesia will be electric, contributing to its broader green energy goals. Thank you so much for watching this episode. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe YNS Indonesia. And yeah, see you in the next video. Bye.